Okay, guys, who's gonna sing the Canadian national anthem?
Canada! Oh, you meant, oh, Canada.
That's the one.
Oh, Canada.
What she was singing was from this. Hello, Canadian Zoo fans. We are here today, the Chandler family, doing a Canadian food taste test challenge, which is really just the snacks that the Estelle family from Canada was kind enough to send to us, along with a baked good we got from a local bakery in Orlando that is owned by Canadians, and some poutine that came from, of all places, Disney. So who's ready to do a food challenge for Canada?
Me!
Let's do it!
Thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe and check out our other YouTube channel for new videos coming out every day. Go to twoinazoo.com and hit subscribe while you're there. Here we go.
Okay, first up, before it gets cold, is the poutine, which is, for those of you who do not know, it is kind of a gravy that's sometimes like a mushroom gravy or a beef gravy. It could be really a different type of gravy with some kind of cheese and fried potatoes, a French fry. Mommy's dying to go first, so go first, Mom. Everyone can try. Let's all try it together.
Yeah,
I don't
know.
Get your cheese too.
That is so good. I love that. Let's start with Caleb. What do you rate it?
I give it a 5.
A 5? Did you eat your cheese? Did you try your cheese?
Yep.
Good. Definitely worth a 5. Timmy?
A 1.
You don't like it? No, it's not your favorite? Okay. Mama?
4. Le Cellier has meat on top of theirs, which makes it like beyond amazing.
Le Cellier is a restaurant at the Epcot. Canadian Pavilion at Epcot, yeah. And theirs is just out of sight. So I was going to give it a 5 until she mentioned that one. So I'll give it a 4. Logan, what do you rate it?
I give it a
5. A 5. Katie?
5.
It's good. So Mommy is divvying out popcorn from our local market. It's plain popcorn, but it is sprinkled with 2 different seasonings that the Estelles sent us. And I don't know that you can get either of these seasonings in our store. And I think the brand is a Canadian brand.
Okay,
so
try the red one first.
We're going to start with, we're going to start with the popcorn that has the red seasoning on it. You ready?
Yeah.
Go for it.
It's good.
It's good? What do you rate it, Katie?
5.
5? Logan?
5.
I will give it a 4. I really like it. Mom?
4.
Timmy? 5? Timmy's all 5s and 1s like usual. Caleb?
I'll give it a 3 because I'm not too crazy. It's like normal food. Like,
it's good. It's pretty decent. Okay. Now we're going to try the next one, which is...
We won't tell you.
Oh, we're not going to tell you. Okay. Try the next one. So Caleb, what do you rate it?
5.
5? Timmy? You got some stuck in your teeth? What do you rate it? A 1. Mama?
2.
2. I will give it a 3. I don't like it as much as the last one. Okay, Logan, what do you rate it?
I give it a 5.
And Katie?
5.
5? How interesting that we had some 5s at the table. Kids, do you know what this one is?
No.
Pickles! Pickles! Pickles!
I knew it was horrible! I knew it was horrible! I knew it was horrible!
The kids hate pickles. They will not eat a pickle on anything. Put a pickle on a grilled cheese, we gotta almost send it back because some of the juice from the pickle got on the grilled cheese. But you guys just gave a pickle a 5.
What?
You gave a pickle a 5. How do you feel about that? So now we're on to chips. Mommy and I have divvied up the chips between all plates, and first, we're out of the 3, we're gonna try the Hickory Sticks by Hostess. Go for it. Mm. It's pretty good. Caleb, what do you give it?
I give it a 5.
A 5? Timmy, what do you give it?
A million?
A million.
Four.
Mama?
4.
4? I'll give that a solid 3. That's good. Logan, what do you give it?
A 4.
Katie?
5.
Very good. Next, we're going to try the Ruffles All Dressed. And that's kind of like a combination of many different flavors. Mama, there's one for you.
Yep.
And one for me. Try it. That's interesting.
It's like a mixture of plain potato chips and barbecue chips.
But yeah, then there's tomato in there. There's like that. Remember the ketchup chips we had with the India challenge? This is like that because there's tomato in this, but it also has onion in it. So interesting. Mm-hmm. Katie, what do you give it?
5.
Logan?
A 4.
I give that a 4. That's very good. Mark? 12. Caleb?
I'm not sure. It's in between the 3 and the 2.
So like a 2.5. Next, we're going to try pickle chips, which we already know the kids like. Don't hand me that. You love these chips. I already know it. Everyone try a pickle chip. Let's go. Dill pickle chips. And I think we have these on our shelf in America, of course, without the French on the bag. I like them. I think they're like a 4. I would eat a lot of those. I like salt and vinegar, and for some reason, those remind me of salt and vinegar. What would you give them?
They actually remind me of salt and vinegar, too, but I don't like salt and vinegar, so salt and vinegar is like my bottom. And these are about a 2.
A step up from that. Mm-hmm. Okay, Timmy, what do you think?
A 4.
A 4? Mm-hmm. Caleb?
A 3.
Logan?
A 5.
5? You love the dill chips. And Katie?
5.
5? So Katie likes pickle through and through. Caleb mm-hmm. wants to say he doesn't, but then when he finds out it's pickle, oh, it's a 1. Next, we have the ultimate maple cream cookie. Mm. As Melanie would say, does it get any more Canadian than a Canadian maple leaf? That tastes like maple. I mean, come on. Let's try it. Let's do it. Mmm. This is one of the best things I've ever eaten in one of our food taste test challenges. So, we're gonna go around and rate these. I'm just gonna go ahead and start with it and say this is a 5. These are incredible. This with a cold cup of milk. Oh, it'd be so good. It'd be so hard not to eat the whole box. Start with Katie. What do you think, Katie?
5.
5.
5.
5.
5.
5-1! We almost never do that. Okay, so now we're gonna try 4 different candies that the Estelle family sent us. These are things you do not find at a cash register or candy store anywhere here in America. Let's start with some chocolate. We're gonna start with the Crispy Crunch.
Okay.
Ready? Eat. This is the Crispy Crunch. It's really good. Let's start with Katie.
5.
5. Logan?
It's a real 5.
I will give it a 4. Mom?
4.
Timmy?
5.
5.
Okay. All five the kids said 5 to this one. Next, we're going to hop over to the Coffee Crisp Bar. Everyone got your Coffee Crisp Bar? Go for it. Mmm. 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 I like that. Let's start with Caleb. What do you think about that, Caleb?
I guess I'll give it a 3.
3? Timmy?
5.
4.
4. It's almost a 5. It could be a 4.5. Logan, what do you give it?
5.
5? Katie?
5.
5? We're going to go to the Wonder Bar. The Wonder Bar. Yep. The last little bit of chocolate you have on your plate. You wonder about the Wonder Bar? Well, let's wonder no more. Let's start with Caleb. What did you think about that one?
2.
2? Timmy?
5.
Mom?
5.
3.
I had this one before.
You have?
When we went to Lake Louise, I had this.
You did?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I've never had it, but I only give it a 3. I like the other 2 more than that one. Mm-hmm. Logan?
5.
Katie?
5.
These two over here have given all the chocolate a 5. Just give me chocolate. And lastly, we are going to the Smarties. This is coated milk chocolate. So I wonder if it's like an M&M. Let's find out. Kind of like an M&M.
This one tastes like an Easter egg.
They definitely have a thicker shell than an M&M. Melanie's right. Okay, Katie, what do you think?
5.
Logan?
5.
I'll give it a 3. It's all right.
3.
Babe.
Caleb? Caleb, you're a 3? Okay. Yeah, that wasn't bad. I definitely like the coffee one the most. That one was so unique and delicious. Okay, lastly, folks, we have a pastry. And it's supposed to be amazing. I don't know. I don't even know what's in it. What's in it? Do you know?
Vanilla custard?
Vanilla custard?
I don't know.
It reminds me of like a deconstructed eclair. You know what I mean? It's called a Nanaimo. And I hope I'm pronouncing that right. I even Googled it. A Nanaimo. A Canadian Nanaimo.
Let's see what's in it.
Cake or something. Hold on. Wait. Slow down, folks. Everyone's dying to get into this Nanaimo. You can kind of see how that looks. It's just beautiful.
Whoa.
Amazing, delicious.
Graham cracker crumbs, walnuts, coconut, vanilla custard, icing, chocolate.
Seems pretty simple. Okay, who's ready? Let's see if we can get a whole thing. Yeah, okay. Ready? Go for it.
Hold on, you gotta wait for me.
Whoa, boy.
Mm. After chips.
scale.
Yeah, buddy.
Man, those maple crackers, you just went down.
Yeah, the maple crackers just got beat.
Yeah. Damn.
That custard is so good.
Oh,
the good thing about this custard is it's not too sweet.
Oh, no.
Sometimes when you get a creme brulee or you get some kind of like an eclair, something with custard filling, it's just to the point that you can't finish it.
I know.
It's just...
makes you shiver.
One bite and it makes you shiver, exactly. So, oh my goodness, is this good though. Mmm. Mmm. Are we ready?
Yeah.
Let's start with Katie. Katie, what do you give this dessert?
Five.
We got our first five. Okay, let's go to Logan. What do you give it?
I five.
Okay, we got our second five.
Mm.
There's no way on earth I could not give this a five. It is so stinking good. It's a five. Mommy, what do you
yes!
give it?
A five, for sure. This is ridiculous.
Okay. Timmy, what do you give it?
Five.
A five? Oh my goodness, one more, and I have a feeling I know what it's going to be. Caleb, look at our viewers, look square in the eye, and tell them what your rating is.
Five.
A five! So I'm going to have to go back through our other taste test challenges and see if any item got unanimous fives. Like, that's incredible that we had two in one video. So what everybody think?
I am so full.
Pretty good, but I am full too. Yeah, I don't even think we're going to eat dinner tonight. We hope you liked this video. We hope our Canadian Zoo fans in particular enjoyed this video. Remember, we do not choose the food for this video. You do. Whenever your country becomes 5% of our overall viewership, then we will do a food taste test challenge for your country. So remember, if you want to see a video like this for your country, just keep spreading the word in your country and we'll see how the viewership grows there. We also want to say a special shout out to Market on South. Say thank you, Market on South.
Thank you, Market on South.
They're a great little bakery and restaurant. You need to check them out. They're even vegan, if you can imagine that. Check out Market on South. You can check out their website actually at marketonsouth.com. I'll put the link down in the description. If you like this video, give it a like, leave a comment, subscribe, and share. And everyone say, see you next time!
See you next time!